We've taken six of the world's top athletes to find out what it takes to make a true Olympian.
Come on, Wiggin, come on.
Testing, analyzing,
15, come on.
Getting under the skin of an elite athlete as we push their bodies to the max.
The physical demands of a biathlete are really incredibly unique. What you're asking an athlete to do is operate at absolute maximum intensity and then within seconds relax to concentrate in order to shoot. Cardiovascular endurance is absolutely fundamental. But on top of that, you have to be incredibly strong. There are huge uphills, there are big downhills, which make it utterly unique.
Monika Hojnisz is one of Poland's most famous sports stars. She's a biathlon national champion, a European Championship gold medalist, and placed fifth in the mass start event at the Olympic Winter Games Sochi 2014. Few sports put the human body through such extremes as biathlon.
Przezwyciężenie swoich słabości jest oczywiście ważne w każdym sporcie. Jest to taki moment, kiedy po przekroczeniu jego jesteśmy z siebie dumni I możemy wtedy wejść na wyższy level.
Monika has been skiing since she was old enough to walk and competing in biathlon from the age of 12. She needs supreme endurance to reach the highest level of her sport. But if she is to medal at Pyeongchang 2018, she needs to excel in many other areas too. Strength, power, cardiac response. To see just how unique Monika's anatomy really is, we're working with Liverpool John Moores University and its world-renowned School of Sport and Exercise Sciences.
Okay, if you swing your legs around to this side and pop your head up that end for me, and just lie back. Great, thank you.
The human body stores fat in two ways, subcutaneously, below the surface of the skin, and viscerally, around the internal organs. A DEXA scan is the best way to analyze Monika's anatomical makeup and really see how she stacks up against the competition. An Olympic female hockey player has a body fat percentage of 14.7, an elite marathon runner only 10.5. Monika's 12.8% puts her firmly in the upper tier of female endurance athletes.
Monika is really interesting. She's 170 centimeters tall, so she's not short, but she's only weighing 49 kilograms. Incredibly light, and she has an exceptionally low body fat percentage at 12.8% body fat. Very, very low, but exactly what is required, because what she is fundamentally is she is muscle.
Na zgrupowaniu często każdy dzień wygląda tak samo. Rozruch, śniadanie, pierwszy trening. Zazwyczaj jest on taki specjalistyczny. U nas biathlonistów jest to tak zwany trening kompleksowy, czyli obiad, najważniejsze w ciągu dnia dla sportowca, czyli drzemka, odpoczynek, potem drugi trening, kolacja. I tak wygląda każdy dzień treningowy. Poniekąd monotonia, ale to jest całe nasze życie.
This is a dynamometer test, and really it's testing strength. Now, of course, Monika at 49 kilos, we don't expect her to have a huge strength output. What we do expect, though, is a very good strength to weight ratio.
The dyno will show us just how much torque Monika's hamstrings and quadriceps can really generate. If she wants to make it to the podium in 2018, she needs to look at every area of her anatomy for those vital marginal gains.
Are you ready? 3, 2, 1, push hard as you can, go on, go on, and relax. Push, up, 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 push, 2, 1, push up, and all the way, push hard as you can, push up, go, and relax.
A typical biathlete may have the build associated with endurance events, but it takes strength and power to ski and pole up to 15 kilometers with a 4-kilogram rifle on your back.
Right, Monika, now we're going to test the hamstring muscles in the back of your leg.
For biathletes, there's a critical trade-off between increased muscle mass and body weight. The lighter Monika is, the less she has to carry around the course, but she still needs muscle for those uphill climbs.
She's only 49 kilos. And so therefore the strength is not massive, but at 49 kilos, the amount of force she produces is exceptional.
The results from Monika's quadriceps combined with her hamstring strength show she's producing the same level of torque you'd expect from a professional footballer. Her ratio of hamstring to quad strength, an indicator of resistance to injury, is almost off the chart and explains why, despite years of punishing competition, she has never missed a day's racing.
Myślę, że mogłabym jeszcze dużo popracować nad moją muskulaturą. Cały czas walczę nad tym, żeby przybyło mi mięśni i dużo treningu siłowego myślę, że może mi pomóc. Trening siły specjalnej. Wiem, że mam jeszcze rezerwy i w tym roku na pewno będę nad tym pracowała.
This heart rate test is a really interesting test because it, to some extent, it personifies what biathlon is. What we expect to see from Monika is whether she's moving to a prone position, in other words, a lying position or a standing position, is that she can control her physiology, a very difficult thing to do, and bring that heart rate down to optimize her shooting performance.
To understand the unique cardiac demands of biathlon, imagine racing a Formula One car flat out for 10 laps and then having to parallel park it several times before racing flat out again. That's pretty close to the control Monika needs to exert over her body.
Two, one, go.
Sports scientist Sam Impey sends Monika on a series of timed runs.
Nice, Monika, well done. Keep that pace.
Pushing her heart rate to nearly 150
okay, Monika,
beats per minute.
When you get in, yeah. Top work, well done.
Then she has just 45 seconds to lower her heart rate.
Great effort, that.
The concentration and control required to hit 5 targets barely 40 millimeters in diameter and 50 meters away is immense. But try doing that after the equivalent of running a 4-minute mile. If Monika is going to become truly elite, she has to be able to shift gears, literally in a heartbeat.
Pace is bang on there, Monika, well done. Really good stuff. So when you come in now, standing recovery, yeah? Really good work that, well done. How are you feeling?
Good.
Monika's results show that her cardiac response conditioning is truly remarkable, effectively reducing her heart rate by half following intense activity to regain the composure necessary to shoot at her optimum performance.
If you take, for example, the prone, her heart rate before she started was 140 beats per minute, and within 45 seconds it dropped below 70 beats per minute. Exceptional.
Tam zawsze jest ta presja, oprócz tego, że mamy wyćwiczone opanowanie oddechu i na treningach potrafimy strzelać same zera, do tego dochodzi presja, mimo to, że wydawałoby się, że jesteśmy dobrze przygotowani, właśnie nie panujemy nad swoim ciałem i nad swoimi emocjami. Zanim jeszcze zaczęłam trenować, zawsze oglądałam biathlon w telewizji. Już wtedy na arenie biathlonowej królował nawet obecny król, czyli Olejner Biedalen. Myślę, że jego wyniki, jego sukcesy i determinacja i to, co osiągał na trasach, determinowało wszystkich i właśnie takie dzieci, jak ja byłam wtedy, to była największa motywacja. Nie wiem, czy to są jakieś wygórowane marzenia, ale na ubiegłych Igrzyskach Olimpijskich zdobyłam 5. miejsce, więc nie pozostaje mi nic innego i przyznać się do tego, jak to, że oczekuję i chciałabym zdobyć lepsze miejsce. No a na pewno podium byłoby po prostu zwieńczeniem mojej wieloletniej pracy.
The VO2 max test is a measure of maximum aerobic capacity. In other words, it's the ability to uptake oxygen, consume oxygen and produce energy. And the athlete simply has to hold on for as long as they possibly can.
For Monika, there is no single test that will demonstrate her physical ability to reach the top of her sport better than VO2 max. The highest recorded scores all belong to Nordic skiers, like biathletes. So if Monika is going to prove herself as a title contender, this is where it has to happen. It will be a psychological as much as a physical battle for Monika to achieve her maximum performance, to push herself all the way to the limits of her endurance.
Really good work, well done. Keep going. Keep going, keep going. pushing. Great start, 15 seconds, we'll go up again.
A biathlete's anatomy is tailored beyond anything else to endure. In a typical Olympic Games, they have to ski across multiple events, nearly 60 kilometers of fast-changing, punishing terrain over a two-week period, with each race demanding maximum physical effort.
Great work, Monika. Well done, well done. Come on, jigging. Keep going, keep going. Really nice, this. Really, really good effort. Keep going. Keep pushing.
At 25, Monika is still a few years from her peak endurance. Most female biathletes don't achieve their maximum VO2 levels until they reach 30. But will her scores see her closer to the pinnacle of performance?
Need some water. Yeah.
As well as Monika's VO2 max, we've also measured her blood lactate levels. Her ability to push herself before the buildup of lactic acid in her body prevents her going any further. Her results proving just how well adapted she is to sustained maximal effort. But it's her VO2 max results that are truly astonishing and really put her in a class of her own.
Monika's VO2 max, absolutely exceptional. 66 milliliters per kilogram per minute is enormous. Interestingly enough, that's the same as Paula Radcliffe when she broke the world marathon record. I've worked in this field for 3 decades and it's probably one of the highest VO2 maxes I've ever seen.
Myślę, że moim dużym atutem jest wytrzymałość. To dzięki niej udało mi się zdobyć dotychczasowe wyniki i jakby w niej się najbardziej, najlepiej czuję.
Push, up, 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 push.
To reach elite-level performance requires an athlete to refine every aspect of their physiology. For Monika, that means not just the skills to shoot and ski, but perfecting the anatomy to generate power, optimize cardiac response, and exhibit supreme endurance. She's delivered in the lab. Now she has to deliver where it really matters, in competition.
Dzisiaj dowiedziałam się dużo. Cieszę się, że mogłam wziąć udział w takim przedsięwzięciu. Dało mi to dużo nowych informacji. Nie wszystkie testy, które dzisiaj wykonałam, miałam możliwość wykonania wcześniej. Także cieszę się, że będę miała i mam dużo informacji po dzisiejszym dniu.
Now for me, biathletes are exceptional athletes, but I think Monika really is truly incredible. What those results tell me is that she's not only one of the best elite biathletes in the world, she is probably one of the best elite endurance athletes on this planet.